Its weight comes a shed of reality for the growing number of Filipinos here in Macau. In what they dubbed as a soft opening, a new Philippine consulate has started receiving inquiries from the first of this month. Citing its aims in delivering services with its growing community, they have the hopes of relieving the stress based not only in frequent demands, but the implications of support as well.
Finally, the long, much anticipative wait is over for the thriving Philippine community here in Macau. In its embodiment comes a consulate that is currently manned by a 10-person staff. The new consul general relates that they have the most positive expectations in breaching the gaps not only with their national stationed here in the region, but also towards the local Macau community all the same.
In fact, when we opened the door to the public at 9 o'clock on September 1, we had a number of people already waiting to have some documents processed, no? Ranging from passports to overseas employment certificates and then other general inquiries.
People were really expecting it.
Yes, yes. Actually, and I had met a number of Filipinos running up to Monday, September 1, because I arrived on August 29, and we had already started to inform people. On an informal basis, and then got in touch with some Filipino community groups and representatives, and so it's spreading, the news is spreading. Besides, we are not yet in full operation, we are still transitioning, and we hope that we'll be able to get into that within the month, within the next few weeks.
In recent years, whenever a Filipino were to require consular services, such as the renewal of passports or the processing of legal documents, they would have to travel to the neighboring special administrative region just to acquire it. It's either that, or they had to wait for a month to get their processes cleared up or inquired upon. In either ways, the endless shout for a demand in the embodiment of consular needs seems a most likely scenario in the enclave.
My first task here is to be able to touch base with the Filipino community representatives. Of course, I made sure that after arriving, my first calls would be with the government of the Macau SAR, and I was able to call on the chief of protocol of the office of the chief executive in September 1, and the commissioner of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs of Macau SAR in September 2. Mm-hmm. Hopefully, I'll be able to arrange calls with the chief executive and the senior officials of and other officials of the Macau SAR in due time.
The move just catapulted the Philippines to be amongst the three foreign offices and the first Southeast Asian consulate to be homed in Macau. Its line of projects and plans so far seems diverse enough to ensure a stable growth with their sociology, citing the aspects of trade and economic relationships, civil aviation, cultural, and even social-political ventures. According to its new consul general, Jaime Victor Leda, there's so much to begin with and so much to learn from this new trend at hand. One thing is for certain, when it comes to the ease of the spontaneous and painstaking wait, the new Philippine consulate is here to stay.
For a number of years, the fast-growing community of the Filipinos here in Macau has long awaited the establishment of their own consular services. Somehow, that call has been answered in somewhat a fashion that would be anticipative of helping the thriving structure. Let's just hope that it would somehow help support the requirements of the Filipino community. This is Herbert Ramos for TDM English News. Back to you, Mia.
Trade between South Africa and Macau.